see all the Swede because all the quality things. So the channel will be kind of the way we are sponsored by
by Coca-Cola.
I don't see PPK. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the weather is there's a bit of a delay, but I think we can start now. I must indicate up front that one of the delays that in my other role as honorary candidate, you know, in the defense, is Armed Force Day. I invited from Friday also to attend the function today. I came to make sure that I do this announcement going back today and tomorrow. For those of you who are clued up with your history, the main day that sunk in the English Channel in 1817 in the celebration of the 100 years. So I was asked to attend, you know, by the command of the big boss. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, it is not business as usual when the chairman of Orlando Pirates Football Club is standing in front of you. It's almost a week ago that I was standing here. The supporters and fans prefer to see the players in the field of play and followed by mainly positive results thereafter. Today is in effect a continuation of last week's media briefing where we dealt with a variety of issues. Let me commence by providing you with an update on the violent incident, the investigation into an incident relating to player Edwin Jima and coach Muslim Edgar. In the violent incident case, footage is being collated for submissions to our lawyers, relevant authorities, the South African Police Service, in order to deal with this matter decisively. An exemplary manner. Orlando Pirates' position is that we should get rid of our matches of elements that perpetrate acts that would, if not dealt with, paralyze our beautiful game. We provide updates on this matter until its conclusion. The player Edward Jima and coach Mushin Ethical matter assumes a different state as Edwin Jima, just before he left for the AFCON, requested that he be released by the club, and that request has been accepted by the club. We therefore continue with the matter internally, as we normally do so to ensure additional processes are truly completed with, complied with. This is done in the form of an exit interview. With the request, just also before the break, in this AFCON season, from Bradley Canal, who asked for permission that he had an offer from a team overseas to extend his career. He just told me that that offer has come through and he's accepted the offer. And he has asked also to be released, which the club has truly agreed to visit. I said last week that violence, the dehumanized issues and emotions that are in the main valid and justified. In the course of addressing the violence I made an omission, I fail to apologize to the true supporters of Orlando Pirates Football Club for the two totally unacceptable results against SuperSport United and Mamelodi Sundowns. As much cannot predict results, but I understand their feelings. The club of Orlando Pirates stature needs to avert these malperformances of that nature. I therefore apologize unreservedly to our supporters for the hurt I know these dismal results caused you and the negative impact they had on your happiness index. We know how being an Orlando Pirates supporter is core to the everyday life of our supporters. We know how the weekly performance of the team affects the mood of the Orlando Pirates supporter. Orlando Pirates supporters are not passive. We do not refer to the club as being an institution separate from themselves. When we lose, Rwanda Party supporters say we lost. And that is precisely where the problem arises. Rwanda Party support base is as diverse and representative as our notable constitution. Rwanda Party supporters are young and old, from every race group, urban and rural. They are teachers, journalists, judges, for courts, policemen, women, Shebeen queens and kings, parliamentarians, and street vendors. Rwanda Party supporters are not only vocal, they are knowledgeable and have a point of view. Most of the Rwanda Party supporters have pedigree. Their support spans more than one generation. The recognition and understanding of these factors that keep us as motivated. It's precisely this recognition and understanding that remind us always that we cannot dry today's washing with yesterday's sun. This metaphor holds particularly true in that yesterday was a sunny day and look today, it's raining. It is against this background that notwithstanding the plans were to install the coach in the beginning of the new season, we fast-tracked the appointment of a coach from a pool of coaches that we have had in our range of consideration. I'm happy to announce Mr. Kjell Jonevret as our new coach. Shetel is J-E-E-T-I-L. This is K-J-E-L-L. Shetel. E, we get the Shetel is not new to those demanding environments. He has coached at levels of the game that gives him a shot and prospect of success at Orlando Pirates. In accordance with the laws of the game of our country, the coach will commence his duties as soon as he receives his work permit. Fred Mbele is here to make sure that whatever happens, the coach must be ready as soon as possible. Like all of us, soccer players are not machines. They are human beings that require nurturing and an ear, especially when things go off the rails. The optimal functioning of a team requires technical fitness and prowess, but it also requires that we get energies in the team to work in concert. That requires a steady hand. Someone who has been in the player's position, someone they trust and respect, someone knowledgeable and encouraging, a good listener that is even tempered, a develop of talent and confidence. Harold, Mr. Queen of Hody, is the closeness embodiment of the characteristics I've just mentioned. Today we announce that the appointment of Harold Tuhodi in assisting the coach with the senior team for more role than what you imagine the assistant coach is going to be of the issues that I've raised above. Ladies and gentlemen, this brings me to the end of my announcement of the coach, Mr. Kjell Jonevret. So he's been able to say, to remind you of a player that year was called after Freddie Kalk. You know, when I used to play football, I used to call Freddie Kalk. You know, that are only national understanding Freddie Kalk.
So, thank you very much.
We need to have to talk to you again.
Okay, hello. I'm going to work with my English, but I hope you understand what I say. I didn't listen to everyone the chairman said, but I'm Swedish. I'm from Sweden, 54 years old, worked mostly up there in Scandinavia, of course, in both Norway and Sweden, and for the last 5 years now in the club in Stavanger in Norway. I lied to you if I say that I knew South Africa football fantastically well, but I have been here with clubs four or five times. I have a few friends down here, so I have tried to watch. I know Stuart Baxter. So of course, I have, especially when he was coach for the Bafana, I watched him a little bit. And I have worked with a few players. Sjebonga Nomvete and Lance Davis I worked with in Djurgården in Stockholm for a few years. I've also worked a little bit with the national team in Sweden as an assistant for the Euro in Poland, Ukraine. And now, but since we decided to go different ways in December, you know, the league in Scandinavia starts up now in March, April, and stops in November, December. So after the last season, when this wasn't now became a reality, I'm looking forward to this a lot. It should be fantastic. And it could be very fun to be here. For me, of course, when you're thinking about African football in Scandinavia, everyone knows about Orlando Pirates. So Orlando Pirates is for me a little bit of African football. So I'm really proud and honored to stay here in front of you today as a new coach for a few years. It's going to be fantastically fun. If there is any questions or thing, maybe we can take that later. I don't know. Is that an idea?
Yeah, yes, an idea, coach. I did not tell them that you have won the league in Norway, you have won the league in Sweden, the coach of the year in Norway, the coach of, I didn't want to do the thing ahead.
Shy,
I think you don't give it to them, you know, the people that are calling or doing the distribution in appropriate time. So that information I didn't talk about. But you put the pro license from UEFA, I didn't want to talk about that because I don't think it's important. The important thing is for them to ask whatever question they want to ask. Because I think it's more than the questions. So if there's any question for the coach for me, so we want to start with more, you want the coach, don't need me. Okay.
Mind the coach.
Okay. Thank you, Chairman. Very long on SABC. I think we'll start with you. Obviously, you've just answered us on some of the things we'd like to know, but what really attracted you to the new coach that you've just announced, especially given some of the challenges that you've had?
But I thought, you know, it was important to acknowledge, as I indicated last week, what happened, that we had to fast track everything. Is staying power in the teams. You know, I think, you know, that's what has been our challenge. We hope that, you know, with the Swedish temperament, you know, which he has shown the teams he has coached, that he has stayed, you know, in those teams for a long time, even if there were challenging circumstances. So we hope that, you know, we find, you know, stay here, and also educators, or perhaps, you know, give us new ways of imparting, you know, his temperament, you know, which I think is very important. And unfortunately, you know, I did say last week that maybe it would be very useful that we get coaches that are not preachers, coaches that are teachers, you know, because more often than not, get coaches that are teachers, you know, they become the center of attraction. You know, we need some boats to assist us to stabilize and also to assist the players, you know, to maintain their confidence, you know, to maintain their performance. He should not be the center of attraction himself. So his mannerism, you know, his temperament, you know, in a short space of time, give me that sense that will help, you know, to stabilize, you know, that situation. So that is one of the main key. Because see, when you talk about qualifications in coaching, I always say that coaching is like an arranged marriage. You hope for the best. Because, you know, if you don't do that, then you're not normal. The coach cannot be changing all over the place. You know, Chelsea had a very good coach in Mourinho. With all the successes, he had one season where everything just went, you know, the other way. It was as if he's a bad coach. He was not a bad coach. So in that, you know, the circumstances which are beyond his control. And the same team, same players, one including, the team's performance number is the top of the rock now. Okay, it's been. So, and that is why for us, we're hoping that he will give him all the support. That's why everybody is here who met us. Yeah, he'll be meeting the rest of the Tinker team soon after a year, you know, to be introduced to most of the members of the Tinker team. Yes.
I am Azola Molefe from the Star. My question is first to the chairman, and then maybe the coach can answer this.
Can you start with, finish with me, then okay. You allow the coach so that it must not be in our dinner.
Okay. Chairman, firstly, just how what is the length of the coach's contract? And secondly, what are the immediate challenges for him? Obviously, this is it's been a roller coaster ride for the club, and obviously the accelerated search to get a coach. What are some of the challenges that you've spoken to him about, and even those that you haven't mentioned to him yet that he faces in lifting the club to perform again?
I think the most important thing is to bring back the confidence of the players, to stabilize the team. Obviously, it's going to be difficult because he was not part of the preseason, even with a short play, he was not part of that preseason. He's in almost the second part of the second season. You know, obviously, coaching is not a temporary solution. Where you've got a headache, you take a Panado, then the headache comes. Doesn't. You know, obviously, we're going to do everything in our power to assist, because they cannot be a scientist who can tell what's going to happen. We do everything possible to make sure that, you know, we touch the ground running with the necessary support from everybody, because it's not going to be easy. Especially with the fixtures that are lying ahead, there's a lot of expectation, but obviously, the reality says that we must be normal people. Because sometimes we expect things that we ourselves can't just achieve. And that's why sometimes the impatience, you know, end up affecting good people. If you can see Van Gaal, how he behaved at Manchester United. It was not only Van Gaal that we know. Arsene Wenger, he said something very interesting last week. When they told him about, you know, the players to their places, well, thank you for telling me about the record. He did not answer the question. Because he understood that this guy is asking something impossible for him to answer. Because obviously in a team situation, there's always going to be something. Now they say to people that when you see the food on the table in your house, wait until you get to the kitchen. You see that the poor woman had to go to the deep freeze to go and get the meat that is in the deep freeze because you are not taking out money to buy meat. But you brought all your friends to come and eat in the house. So you must put all the spices and whatever to make the meat smell nice. So the meat, you know, is so 6 months old in that deep freeze. Because you can't tell your friend that this man is not spending money to buy food. So we must make do. You know. So there's so many problems in the kitchen that sometimes you find a way of how to solve them. When you go out, there's no excuse. So the coach, you know, is coming to a situation not like that. You know, you don't buy groceries, you do buy groceries. There is a grocery in the kitchen. You know, but it's a question of making sure that, you know, whatever ingredients that he brings in, you know, you just stand back and allow him to, what you call it, give him the space. You know, it's very important. So that his new ideas, obviously, he's got to know the player, the technical team, and also talk about his philosophy, you know, of doing things. So our support, I think, is very crucial at this stage of the season. The 3-year contracts that we always emphasize with the coaches, wanted to be longer, but the 3 years, you know, I think, is a reasonable, you know, term for every coach to be able to do justice, you know, to the appointment that he's.
Chairman, you exited the merry-go-round of the coaches that have been doing rounds, and most of the coaches, some of the coaches are unemployed currently, but you decided to go out into the Scandinavia and get a new man in the South African football scene. What are the thoughts that drove the chairman to go through and go out of the continent rather than to look for a new man in the scene?
Well, there was nothing new available as easy as it makes, because also it does not necessarily mean those coaches, most of them were coaches in the national teams that, you know, were available. Whether that was going to be helpful, I don't know, at club level, I don't know. You know, and that's why I'm saying that, you know, if there was a coach ready, you know, like the one that he was touted from Team Mazembe, he signed a contract in Egypt, you know, so he was keen to come. You know, but he signed a contract in Egypt. So it's not easy to watch court, but you better get somebody who's dealing with the players day to day, instead of reinventing the wheel. So I think in terms of what we got in and shared, I think, you know, we are happy for now.
Once again, Chairman, you like scooping the media, in terms of bringing in somebody that was unexpected. The issue here is that you've reinforced even the technical team for the coach with bringing in an experienced guy like Jesse Kunlehodi. What was the reason behind that, and what is going to be the role of Benson Mhlongo? When Lucky retired, we thought that he was going to be given a position within the Orlando Pirates setup. What is it any time soon with that one?
You're asking me a difficult question here, Mr. Kekan. You've just heard that Brady Canelli has left. And what will the coach do with one core assistant? I think as a footballer, analyst, you should know that every team has two, three assisting people to the coach. So if now you ask the development institution, I can understand how to answer that one.
No, with specific reason, because again, there's the Disky business team as well, which Zippo has left.
But you're telling as if now with somebody coming in, but I don't have a job.
No, it
can't be that question. It can't be that question. He's an assistant coach in the senior team. And now I talk about just coming in, therefore it means now he's not going to have a role. What's going to happen of him? That's a follow-up, the implication of what you're saying. So, he's going to be there, he's got a role to play. With Lucky, obviously, we did indicate to our players that it's important for them to get the necessary qualification. He's making an effort to do that. Because it's important that, we have quite the players, and we always talk to them about they still play. That it's important to join that team, especially towards the ending of their career, to empower themselves in making sure that they get those qualifications. So that when we deploy them, we must not throw them in the deep end. Football has become very scientific now. It's not as good enough that you've got your talent alone and experience of the coaches. Maybe those coaches that we are using, the technology we're using is no longer applicable. So he's yesterday son. So therefore it's important to be current. So he's busy empowering himself. Not only him, another one that is going to be joining us soon. Maybe the son announcement of him to come and join us.
Chairman, what would the message be to the players and even the fans in terms of with the coach coming in, and what is a difficult time to with the club and to help him settle in? And last week you talked about the fact that you'd have a message with the players to find out where they're at mentally and stuff like that. What came out of that meeting in terms of where the players' mental aptitude is at?
I think, losing, obviously affects their confidence also. They're human. And obviously they don't want to be measured that in the 80th celebration, this is how they want to be remembered. They want to be remembered in that way. And we understand also from the team, without giving any excuse, that we've never experienced this only because we've been very quiet and without complaining and so many things, that we're variables out there affecting the team. This is the most troubled team. For so many years, they've been very consistent, and obviously, at some point, it must take its toll. And obviously, by the point of also changing over, refurbishing the team, it takes time. And like I said, that when you're playing so many games before, we never had to go to the media. The league is doing it. We never complained, not because it was normal. It was to find the challenge as motivating to say, how do I adjust? Well, that's where you learn when you face with challenges. You say how to overcome this in the future, because if you start complaining, you deny yourself a chance to learn out of that experience. So we are learning, out of this experience, and obviously going to the future, we have solutions, to say how to avoid it also. Because really traveling in the continent, it's tough. Like I said last time, two of my players, especially Manisa, who's still alive, you can see what happened to him. Because there's no player in this kind of play 52, 53 games in one season. There's no player. And he played coming back today, going to the national team, coming to the national team, going to the continent domestic. Because the coach, they felt that without him in the team, that's not good enough. There's another challenge sometimes that, there's not enough rotation of players. But we saw happening in Manchester United when they came against Blackburn, you know, and you can see how they try to recycle the players. When the signals were showing, they had to bring, you know, the big guns to assist, you know, to close the game. Because they're trying to rotate the players all times. At home, yeah, the supporters say, yeah, one source is not playing, why didn't he play? In terms of important, because all those 23, 25 players, they're equally good, all of them. It also helps the coach at the appropriate time when, you know, he needs them, to allow them the game time, you know, in rotating the players on the bench. So the players are aware that, you know, the pressure is too much. In the last 2 games, we'll see that they wanted to play. They are playing. Because they find within themselves also, sometimes they need to be reminded, not because they are not aware of their responsibility. They are human beings, you know, they are young, they need the necessary support. The coach that was there, he obviously challenged making sure that, you know, he gets things going. So it's not easy, but I'm happy that, you know, we had a very interesting discussion, which is continuing. Even today, we are discussing about meeting with them again. You know, we had a very special, you know, meeting today with the players again, talking about these issues. So, and we had hope that, you know, we need also get somebody who's going to be very close to them, because the technical side is the technical side, but there's human issues. Human resource issues, insofar as, you know, players are very shy people. They don't just talk open. You need somebody who's going to be able to understand their psyche, their persona, to get, you know, the real problem. Because they always dribble you when they tell you the story. So you need somebody who's going to come in, to be closer to them, even assist us. You know, even if there's an issue that need to be attended, you know, readily. Hopefully, it's going to give us another dimension in assisting them, you know, to keep on the rail at all times.
Chairman Mazolo Mulefegian from the start. Just curious to find out how you were able to find the coach. You know, how extensive was the search when you got his CV? Was it an obvious choice to have him as one of your candidates, or was it a daunting task?
It was not an obvious choice. I mean, for you, those of you saw the thing with the kickoff or what? with the kickoff. Yeah, that guy was also considered, you know, but, you know, unfortunately, the agent, you know, he wants to be the main actor. You know, he wants to be the main actor because you can see how far we've gone, you know. To make sure that we extend our search, you know. You know, unfortunately, we also sent a letter of invitation to talk to them. Now, not because they wanted to have their press conference they must have it there. You know, because we can't do things like that. It's a serious business. If you want to be the main actor when we've got problems, challenges, I mean, it's not an ordinary club. It's not ordinary country. I mean, if people want to treat us, they must treat us with respect. Because when we invite you, don't come into us the favor. Yourself, you know, the main actor. So we felt that, you know, let us not deal with that issue. So a few of them we've spoken to make sure that we need what we have, you know, at that present moment. So just not the okay that one. It is that maybe there's a proof, you know, that it's somebody, you know, also was also considered. So there's so many people that were considering. So it happened to be him that we, you know. Even at home, yeah, a lot of things were happening. Why are you laughing?
I'm smiling, Chris.
What do you know? What do you know? Tell us.
I don't know anything. Afterwards.
So now you're the coach now too.
Yeah, he's the coach.
Okay. Coach, evidently you probably have applying for the position, had to extensively check in terms of Orlando Pirates and his pedigree. What would you bring that's different coming from Scandinavia? And have you done more search about the type of players and how they play at Orlando Pirates?
Yeah, I can't tell you the difference between the coaches who work right here right now, but I'm going to do what I normally do. And I think that's the thing that Orlando Pirates want from me also. So I'm going to continue with what I do. But of course, I have seen them play now for a few games. There's a very talented group of players, but a little less of confidence, I think. And so it's a little bit now to start with. Of course, you have to back to basic and start a little bit all over. Not going to change everything. I'm going to sit down with the staff and the coaches today and discuss what they. I think I've been good. What we can do better. So I think we have to wait and see. It's no often football is no quick fix. It takes some time. But of course, now in the situation that Paris are now, I think it's 7 or 8 games in a row without a win. I think it's also important that we try to win a game as quick as possible, get some happiness in again, and laugh in the locker room. I suppose they're a little bit down there, could be. So, to answer your question, I'm going to continue doing what I normally do, and maybe you're going to find out that a little bit later.
Really from Daily Sun. How much did Stuart Baxter have in your decision to come here? Do you know him well? And also, it's 9, by the way, it's 9 games that Pirates haven't won. So.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
And how do you think you're going to fix the team in the short term? Yeah. Because this team is normally winning cups, and it looks like they're not even going to make the top 8.
Yeah. I don't want to stay here and say things about coaches who have been working before me here. I'm sure they have done absolutely everything to win games, but of course there have been a few ugly ones. When I see Paris playing, I think you have to start a little bit again to work with in defense. There's some really stupid goals, and that also affects on the offense, because if you're wrong in defense, you're also going to have problems when you attack. So I think and it could be nice also for the players to listen to a new voice. I'm sure it's not going to be any big things, but just small things with players. But I have only watched games on bad lines over on broadcasting now, so it's also different to say, but I think that's going to sort out pretty quick. About Stuart Baxter, no, I don't know him so very well. But he was—I worked in a club in Stockholm as an assistant in the beginning of, it was in the end of '90s, AIK, and he was—he went in for us as a head coach there, and they asked me if I want to stay and work with him. I was assistant there before, but my choice was to go away. But then we have met each other many times. When we have played each other and things like that. And I also looked in a few national team games when he was here working with Bafana Bafana. So I know him, and of course I'm going to talk with him a little bit also if he just answers the telephone now that we are rivals. but we see. But I don't know him very well, but I know him.
Coach, I noticed that you spent most of your coaching life in the Scandinavian area and also Eastern Europe. Sometimes people talk about how difficult it is to move outside your continent.
Yeah.
And obviously you've seen that coaches from your world have been successful on the continent. What do you think is important for you as you start this journey?
It's a little bit the same there as earlier there. I think I have worked with a lot of African players, mostly maybe from Nigeria, Senegal, different countries, and some way they often people think that you're good working with them. So I don't really know what it is, but I'm prepared for that. It's totally not totally, but it's a big difference from Scandinavia down here. Of course, I understand that, but I also, as I said, it's going to be a little quick fix. I'm gonna learn. Of course, I'm going to learn, but I'm going to talk with the people, and we're not going to change everything. We're going to still have a group of people in the staff who know where it is, and I'm going to listen to everyone. But the same again. I should try to be myself, and it had worked earlier. There have been many good African players that I worked with who are playing in bigger leagues right now. So I think I should be myself. I don't know if that was an answer to the question, but I know, and I have talked with Lars Lagerbäck, for example. He's the coach in Nigeria for one in the World Cup, and I know that it's different. I know that, but it's going to be exciting. It's really exciting to learn a new culture also. Yep.
Coach Tsapang from Soweto. Coach, how much of a challenge is it coming in the middle of the season when you're under pressure to get the results and there's no preseason? And what type of football can we expect to see Pirates playing under your guidance?
Full speed forward, tight backwards. It's always difficult, but at the same time, today, it's most of the clubs changing coaches in the middle of the season. If not every year, but they do. So it's pretty normal right now to step in. And also, that could be, as I said, it could be good for the group of players to some. I'm not a fan of kicking coaches, and I don't think you get the result directly. Most of the time, but in this case, I think it could be good for the players to know, listen to a new voice, and what type of football I play. I think we should try to find the Orlando Pirates way to play football. I like to have a game. If you talk numbers like 4-4-2, 4-3-3, or whatever, it's for me it's more numbers. But I like to play an offensive football. But the base I've always we need a good defense. Good defense, but I like to have a passing game football. But also in Scandinavia, they work a lot with possession, of course, but also contra. So I think we should find our own way to play, and hopefully it's going to be successful. If not first week, I think we have to do it second week because I think it's KC Chiefs second week. Huh? So we don't have too much time then.
Coach, says to proceed from CGTN. Just for my colleague's sake and all due respect to the chairman, how do you pronounce your name?
I think I'm going to have big difficulties to pronounce a lot of your names here. But my first name is Shell. Little bit like the oil company. Just in KJ instead of A. And the second name is Jonevret. Jonevret. Coach is working great. But we can spell it later. But Jonevret. My father once was named Johansson. In Scandinavia, half of the people there is Johansson. So my father decided to change name. Don't ask me how we find that one, because it's tough even for people in Sweden to say. But it's Jonevret.
Coach. Len Muleko from AN7. Despite the objective that you've been given by the club, have you sort of like set out your target in terms of where you see the club finishing at the end of the season?
I think it's stupid to talk about what's going to happen in the end of the season right now. Because when you're in a situation like this, you have to take every day, go to training, work hard every day, and hopefully that gives you a good game Sunday, Wednesday, or whatever you play. First of all, we are now Pirates of, is it 10th place? Yeah, and probably like 10, 15 points behind. So I think it's stupid to talk about medals right now. Let us play a few games and see. It's the daily work who are going to give us the results that we earn in the end. And that's very in the use to talk about what's going to happen in June right now. Gotcha. Yeah.
Coach Trevor Cromer from Jacaranda FM, local radio station.
Okay.
In your discussions with the chairman and taking the job that you have, would it have been made aware to you what the South African football culture is all about? The expectations of fans, the size of clubs, the magnitude of Orlando Pirates and Kaizer Chiefs, and obviously the responsibilities associated with a club the size of Orlando Pirates and the expectations of the fans and obviously the board and everybody associated with the club?
Yeah, of course we have talked about that. I know that it's more than football in a club like this. But I have worked in a few big clubs in Scandinavia, in Stockholm, so I know a little bit of it. But of course, but they have informed me, we have discussed it, we have talked about it, and I'm prepared for it. But you never know how you're going to respond. But hopefully we're going to have a... I'm not here just to do a work for a short period. I want to be here for long. I want to stay down here and this should be a talk about marriage earlier. I hope I'm the beautiful wife. So you're going to keep me here for long. But of course, I'm prepared for that. But you never know how you react when you're in it.
Coach.
Yep, sorry.
Coach, you come into the country, into a team rather, that has got, this is on a rocky patch right now. And I'm sure you said you've watched their last two games.
I lost a few more, yeah.
Yes, and hopefully you didn't watch the Sundowns one with the...
I don't.
I'm going to the stands, actually. Just to add to what Trevor is saying, it's more than football, and the fans here can be physical. Coming into a team that has got a situation right now where there was spectator violence due to what has been happening within the team. How much of that are you prepared for being looked at as a messiah to come and rescue the sinking ship?
I don't see myself as a messiah, I promise you that. But when it comes to supporters who are fighting and things like that, I think it's not too usual here. It's not happened too often.
Yeah.
No. Mm-hmm. So, but... As I said, in Stockholm, there are three big clubs in Stockholm, and they stop games almost every week there and fights and things. So I know about that. I know how to react on it. And of course, the club have to react on things like that. But I think we take it when it. I hope it's not going to be like that again, because that's sad. Let us play football. Football should be, as we said, football is fun. Football should be something for everyone. I know now families back in Sweden, they don't want to go to the games because they're afraid of the kids. But from what I've heard, it's much better here, even if things happen often. But football is passion. People are living out all their energy on the tribune and let it be like that, because that's what we want also. But of course, we shouldn't fight each other.
Yeah. Joe, from the start, like you said, that you'd like to stay here long and hopefully be seen as a beautiful bride. Most of the coaches here have resigned more than being fired. I mean, and the coach said that one of the things that attracted to you was your staying power. What is it? What's behind that? And what do you think will be key in terms of you staying here for a long time?
What I mean is that when we have discussed, as I said, if you want to build a team who is good, more permanent, I think you can't change the stuff every year or every second year or every 6 months or something. You have to work. It's like every, all of it, I think it's the same for you. If they change your boss all the time and you have to do something else, or he say, no, we should work on this way, it's going to be tricky for you for a while. But after a while, when you have worked with him for a little longer, then you feel confident. And you know how it is. And it's the same with football. I think we should, both staff and players, and find a way to play, to learn and develop it, instead of just starting all over all the time. It's difficult. It's difficult to start all over too often. So, and I mean, then you have coaches who just want to be a short period sometimes. But my last two clubs now are in Stavanger, and I've been in another club in Molde. I've been there for 4.5 years. In each club, and then it's much easier for you if the club lets you work. Of course, you have to have results in a club like Orlando Pirates. I understand that, but it's easier to get results if you feel that the club believes in what you are doing, and that you can work for a little longer period, longer perspective.
Thank you, coach.
Thank you. Yeah, time to drink.